is Terry Orr. I'm with All the Arts for All the Kids Foundation. I'm going to guide you through an art project you can do at home looking at kente cloth from Africa and pattern. Pattern is a line shape, color, image, number, comes up more than one time, but in the same order. For example, red, green, red, green, square, square, circle, square, square, circle, or even black and white stripes.
Kente cloth is intricately woven fabric coming from the West African country of Ghana. There's over 350 different types of patterns, making it a perfect inspiration for our project.
Now we'll move into our art project. You can use any materials for this project, such as markers or crayons or starting with a Sharpie, and you can use any color paper. For this one, I like to change the size of the paper into just a little bit long, thin rectangle. So I have the size that I want to start with. Here are three ideas of how to create a pattern. Remember, these are just ideas. There's so many ways to create a pattern. These are just three suggestions. One way is to draw a line kind of in the center. If you were to do this one, you would do a pattern on the top and a different pattern on the bottom. A second idea is to do lines at the top and at the bottom, just kind of creating a middle section for a pattern. If you really want a straight line, you can take another piece of paper, kind of place it down where you want to make the mark, and use the edge of that paper to create a straight line. Again, you don't need to do it this way. This is just if a straighter line is something that you're going for. If you did this one, you would then add a pattern right in the middle and maybe two smaller patterns at the top and at the bottom. The last way that we can go about creating a pattern is a grid, kind of dividing up our art into four quadrants. If you were to do this way, you would do a different pattern in all four quadrants. Now we want to start creating our patterns. Sometimes I like to think about shapes and I start by creating a shape pattern. For example, I could do triangle, circle, something like that. Another way I like to come up with patterns is thinking about lines. I might try and mix it up and do an ABB pattern. I might do a straight line, wavy line, wavy line. Straight line, wavy line, wavy line, straight line, wavy line, wavy line. I know I'm also going to color this one in, so I might even make a section of just rows or grids so that I can create a color pattern when it's time to color. I like to go back in and make some of my lines thicker lines and some of my lines thinner lines. It can make a more dynamic art piece to. Now we can move forward with coloring them in. Again, there's the option to just keep it black and white, or you can use markers or crayons or watercolor, whatever coloring tool you have to fill these pages with color. Maybe think about adding a color pattern. How I go about adding a color pattern is I find two colors that I really like. Like I might do yellow and red, and I might do a yellow, red color pattern. Now that I have the majority of my patterns colored in, one thing I do as a finishing touch is I like to go in and see if there's any small little areas that I missed. I can go back in with my marker or crayon or whatever coloring tool and just fill those in, just as a finishing touch to get the whole page colored in. Thank you so much. Take a look at some of these finished examples and remember to create a pattern of something you like, something that inspires you.